Hello, everybody. Welcome back. All right. Let's, you know what? Let's just go up to Lindenvale, and then I think we can just go over to, Baron. Get some of that fun stuff out of the way there.
Come on,
go back
Roach.
And get those other question marks at the other town later. Need to level up to get to some of these quests, which means you really have to do mainline quests to get like the serious experience.
Went to the forest for brushwood yesterday.
I thought there was a scavenger hunt. No one does Witcher contract. Talk to the gravedigger. Level 10.
Hey, do not hear their huntsman.
Where's that? Oh, right there. Get this Witcher contract.
Come on.
I think we can do a level 10.
Glory is still unwell. That's hot as a half. As you see.
Hear about the job. Seems you've got a problem. Some graves get dug up.
If that were only it. Every now and then, a vile beast had come round the graveyard. Devour what's fresh, then move on. Started again not long past. Thought to myself, just don't step out after dark and lock your door tight. But then a young'un went missing.
From the graveyard?
Nay, from the village. Little snotter wouldn't have come here of his own. And I'd heard something like a whimper in the night.
Didn't bother to come out, see what was happening?
Think me daft. If you've monsters, you need a witcher.
Let's talk about my reward.
240's pretty nice.
Just the tiniest bit, dear. But we'll settle soon, I can see that. Haggling's as much an art as... Rate's fair. Considering the job, I know a bit about these things.
Okay.
See if I can learn what's out there.
This is saying that it's a skull. Nah, I can't. If it's a skull, I can't beat it. I mean, you can. It would take an excessive amount of tries, and y'all don't want to sit here and see me try it like 30 times, probably, so. What's faster? Heatherton? I guess we'll just go over there on foot. We might see something. I saw level 10, and I was like, okay. If it's like, if it's not a skull, if it's just like 5 levels higher or something, then, you know. But you start, you just don't do any damage. I mean, you saw with that Ekimaru, like, I think he was healing faster than I was hurting him. Like, maybe if I sat there for an hour and a half or something and strictly tried to beat him, I probably could. If I got, like, a really, really lucky pull and just played it absolutely perfectly, maybe. Faster saddle. Right, let's go over here and try to get this horse race. I think that's where it is. Actually, whatever. There's.
Right, Roach.
Might be a quest that's sent me this way. The monster cave. What kind of monsters?
Thank you.
Those level 9s, like 10 of them. I just need a better sword for that. They start to get, like, percentage bonuses on you, too. Like, they have more health, but I think your stuff is also less effective as they go higher and higher in levels over you. Where is this? I don't like the look of this. Well, okay, well, we can't do the Gravedigger quest anyway, so there's not really a boss there. So we can just ride back over to the dragon place and just fast travel up there. Because like I said, I could probably beat those kind of things. Like, I'm sure I could do that, but it might take me several attempts, and I do want to actually try to get through as much of the game as we possibly can, so I don't want to spend too long trying these kind of heroic battles. We'll have some of them. I'm not going to just take the easy mode stuff, but I want to pick our fights. I think trying something like the Ekimara is fun, but just beating ghouls. I mean, we see ghouls all the time. Okay, it's just a pack of 6 high-level ghouls here. Annoying to deal with. How did I not find this? Nice if I could get something that starts working like the main quest line. At least one little part of that every episode or two. Okay, where? I guess we're going right here. Actually, hold up. I'm pretty sure there's some of that stuff in the north is pretty useful too, but I think I have to be higher level for that.
Don't let him catch his breath!
looks like there's some structures. Usually there's a quest or just some kind of something to fight. Okay, here we go.
Buy in or just...
Wouldn't mind a few rounds of cards.
Nilfgaard. Nilfgaard usually has some pretty strong archer units, so hold on to that. Okay. Pretty good hand. Put a spy on me, huh? Spies are melee. That's a very good card, by the way. There, it kills like their melee if they have more than 10 power or something. They still have a torrential rain, which is not great news for us. Oh, wow. They pass? I mean, I could use my medic and get a free spy. How much is the spy worth? 7. So that means they would... Well... Means I'd have to use 2 cards. I'm gonna have to use 1 card anyways. We don't have the other one of these guys. So if I throw down the medic, grab the dude, and then I'd have to play 1 more, I'd be neutral on cards instead of +1. Did that. I don't know why he gave that up. I guess because I'm up a card or something, and he just wants to hold. Because now I guess he can use the torrential rain, which is actually going to be quite good against me here. I've got a fog though as well, unless he has a ton of melees. Okay, that's really good for us. This is gonna be bad. We're gonna have to go for the spy. Let's hope that we draw something good here. Oh, we did get Biting Frost. Okay. So basically, unless he has a clear weather. And then everybody's gonna be weak, so it's just gonna come down to who has keeps more cards on the board, or if he has a horn. I effectively have a horn with my passive. He may not have a Torrential Rain in his deck, it's possible. I don't even need a Biting Frost if he doesn't die. Okay, I want to force him to go ahead and use that Rain, so that if he has a clear weather card, then he's going to clear the weather on the ranged as well. Because if I fog right now and he has a clear weather, it'll get rid of the fog, but it won't get rid of the rain. So I want him to throw down the Torrential Rain here. He can Torrential Rain next turn, but now he doesn't have a clear weather for the fog. Is this fog even worth, though? Let's see, I've got 11. I've got 16 value right now in ranged. And he only has, let's see, 9. He only has 14 that I can, that's foggable. So actually, it's not good for me to fog this. I have 10. He has 11 right here. So Biting Frost would net us 1. Oh, he's not he didn't even have a Torrential Rain in his deck. Okay. Alright, we just win then. Scoia'tael card. Yeah, that guy. Alright.
Buy in or just per.
Show me what you've got.
Have that? Cascool gear die. They already have this? Cascool gear first. Okay. So he's selling it for 15 gold when I already did it. Is that the one that I already had? It's gonna be annoying.
Good plow.
Gossips. Armor. Usually there's not that much that's important.
Yeah?
Craft special order weapons too?
Do politicians murder high class prostitutes? Course.
Gwent, baby. Rich off the cards.
Up for a few rounds of Gwent?
I think a 4 is weaker than my average draw, so... If it's weaker than your average draw, you should go ahead and just throw it. Alright. Take that. Is this the go find frost fog? Okay. I don't like the go find stuff as much as more proactive things like this, like doubling your army, basically where it counts as a card, so I don't have to run a fog in my deck if I don't want to with that. Okay, throw this guy out there. Go ahead and use full test here, probably. See if he has a torrential rain or not. Okay, yeah, let's blow out. So we get to get a card because we won, and then we get to use Thaler. Thaler is one of the best. Zero cost. I think he is the best guy because he can be resurrected. Different abilities. There's one that's a zero cost that's not one, but it's a hero card and can't be resurrected, so. We have two of these guys. We want to save our melee for next round if we can. So we want to try to use all of our non-melee stuff if we can. Okay. Yennefer is very good. She's resurrection and she's got 7 power, which is nice. We're still a little bit ahead, not much. He does have a fog, so we gotta be a little careful. In theory. We can match him, so if he fogs, it'll hurt him just as much as us. They won't give him this, because everything else I'm going to get no value out of this turn. He's gonna get to draw another card. If it takes him 2 cards to get it, we should definitely crush him. If he gets it in 1 card, okay, it's gonna take him at least 2 cards. He just can't even get it. Oh, how did he draw a card? Now he's clear weather. Okay. Still, we're still tied after all that. Okay. Chaos Behemoth. Okay, so that's a monster card.
Yeah?
Alright, let's see what he's got here. Craft something.
Got this
diagram.
I haven't
even kept up with what's craftable here. What is this for? I'm not sure. Hypersolar Dorian. Okay, all of those are high level. Second map. Do I have this? I thought it would tell us if we had it or not. -85 slashing damage. Oh, that's the average or something? We're just gonna find a lot of weapons, so I don't think we need this as much. Yeah, getting that diagram's alright.
So long.
Okay. Okay, part one. See everybody in town? Check these last couple out. Loop here.
And whosoever finds the Baron's
here.
Daughter will
maybe
not go unrewarded.
Conspicuously isolated. Somebody there?
Buy in or just peruse him?
Show me what you've got on.
Okay, this is the guy from the town. It just turned into nighttime, so then he came back here, I guess.
So long.
Okay, where are we going next? South.
An old feeble woman.
What's wrong?
T'other night, blasphemers pox take and profane the shrine to Verna the Merciful. Shrine's gotta be repaired, else Verna will take umbrage. Our cows will croak, our kitties will be covered in warts, and our dogs will get the mange.
Warts and mange? Sounds dangerous. Fine, I'll help you.
Have sent ye to me. Someone to repair their shrines from this day on.
Look, already got a trade. I'm a witcher. Restoring traditional roadside structures in wood, just not my specialty.
Fighting evil, that's a witcher's calling. And vandals are worse than beasts.
Fine. I see any damaged shrines, I'll take care of them. Won't go out of my way, though.
Nothing's out of the way in these parts, and the gods will guide ye. You look awful.
Alright, where are these shrines? They're pretty far out of the way. They're down there. I mean, we'll go down there eventually, but... It's nice to pick up this stuff along the way, so you can kind of multitask, right? If we get three or four quests in an area.
Go, go.
Get them all out of the way.
Just destroy it.
Okay. Yeah, I think that is actually the place. It's gotta be a certain time of day, though. To go talk to somebody about figuring out about those, I guess. I guess it could be right there, maybe? I thought it was right here. Yeah, because that's like the loot. Alright. Horse racers are just kind of fun. They're actually sort of, the early ones especially, they're kind of challenging, so you don't have a lot of gear. And I want to get that so I can get a faster saddle. I think it just upgrades stamina. Upgrades speed or not. Whatever. I think we have something in the town to figure out about that.
Yeah.
There's an elven burial ground in the caverns near the elves. We'll use some hair of that monster's room. Where did he go, Captain?
Spot a sight of.
Like to take a look.
Fire Scorpion's a good no card card.
How about a few rounds?
You see trouble? Don't. It'll point.
think that's the torrential rain ones. Get that out of there. We did get one more of these tight bonds, I think. Frost. He doesn't have a clear weather. Okay, nice. Got the fog out of him. And he doesn't have any more fogs in his deck, because that just showed up as red. I'm pretty sure. Do this. If he clears the weather, then it's going to clear his fog, too. Catapults we can use next round. Revive cards are obviously very strong. Great with spies too. They use spies on you. Okay, now we have our fog. Torrential rain. Alright. That's gonna be a tough workaround. Okay, we can go ahead and use our melees this time. They put down too much rain. Watch out for Scorch. That's the tight bond. Scorch can just totally ruin you. Ooh, okay. I do have impenetrable fog also. Man, everyone's got Yennefer. I mean, it's kind of worthless by himself, so we might as well get 4 value out of that. The same as I would have if I played him solo. Okay, now... he's still really far. Oh, because of the Yennefer. If he wins, he's gonna get one more card. I try to fight through all these. If he has another hero card, it's gonna be pretty tough. Can I win? Okay, so if I think I just pass, I might lose this one. It's gonna give him a card though. He has two more. Does he really have, can he have any more hero cards? If I put this down, it's gonna give one more, and then I can double all of them. I kind of like that idea. I don't think he's gonna have another hero card. But if I give him one more card, we'd be tied on cards. And then his cards are probably higher than mine, because I just have a 4 and a 5 right here, which aren't that great. Okay, so he passed, so I just win. And if he wins a round, he gets to draw a card too, so then we would have been even on cards. It would have been looking sketchy. Sounds like a Scoia'tael card. Some of these are very different from what I remember. Shark, okay. Not monster, is he? No. Oh, that's a spy. Okay, that's pretty good. Yeah, that's Scorpion that we bought too. Like 10-10. I mean, it's about getting there. We want to switch over to Nilfgaard here pretty soon. Not quite there yet. Torrential Rain.
You white one. Looks like you put
snakes in the muscles.
Okay. 23 minutes. Okay. We're supposed to do Baron just yet, so. I think it's fine. If we can get in there, we might have to do something else first. He might send us a request first if I can.
Depends who's asking.
A witcher. Want to talk to him.
Hmm. Yeah. And I want to plough the lovely Queen Seru.
Seen this man before?
In at the crossroads. You was there not so long ago. Thought you were supposed to go your separate way, nice and all.
In at the crossroads. I'm trying to remember. Oh, yeah, I didn't kill them all at the end.
It led me here. Gotta talk to the Baron.
Oh, aye. What about?
Something important. His ears only.
Yeah,
fine. Lodrin, let him in. If he makes any trouble, well, we outnumber him.
Open the gate.
Yeah, I think if you kill all the people Sergeant. In the bar, you might have to go do an extra quest or Argyle. Something, but because I spared him.
Witcher, to see the Baron.
I think.
Don't want no disturbances. That clear.
What do you think?
Sir,
Guard called you a sergeant. You a Temerian soldier?
Some of them is mammons, flying drakes, pikes, oh, and bats.
Not your concern, mate.
Deserter.
Temerian army don't exist.
So what are you all doing here?
Had a choice after the Black Ones thrashed us. Let it lie and try to lead normal lives. Or continue to resist, join the guerrillas and fight for our beloved Temeria till death do us part. We chose the former.
And the Baron, your commander?
Hmm. Yeah. Commander. Oi, where the fuck
Help
are you
me
going?
Assist you.
Well, I hope you like Gwent in this episode. Sorry if you don't, but...
Yearning to play a few rounds of Gwent. That ought to set me straight.
But we're just running into a bunch of people this time. Let's fire it up. See, it doesn't get doubled by the horn, though. Could be walking right into torrential rain, but we'll make her have it. Give it to us, huh? Wow, she did a horn, but she didn't want to put any more down on it. That's pretty bold. Nothing good to resurrect here. Yeah, I guess we hold on to that for one more round. She's still got a frost. Let's see if we can bait it out with this, maybe. I guess we'll go with this, just because we do have frost and fog. So if they don't have torrential rain, we can lock up the other two rows this turn. If she has a clear weather, it could get a little tricky. But we'll make her have it. Maybe I played that wrong. Maybe I should have done, I should have played out the two commandos first, and then force her to use her Biting Frost, and then use the Clear Weather would have cleared it, if she had a Clear Weather, so I'd sequence that poorly. I'm messing up all over the place. I should have held on to this and just went ahead and baited the Biting Frost, I think. Because I'm going to have to bait it out either way. Should probably go ahead and use it right here. So if I get 12 more, that's going to force her to frost. This might be the first round that I lose. Let's see. So we're both gonna have one card left. If it's a melee card, I think I win, because I have a Biting Frost. Okay, woo! We're gonna win with one. One power, baby. All right. Yeah, I would have done that a lot better if I baited the frost and then did the fog so that her clear weather would clear the frost. That's what I should have done. Look at him all walking off. He's mad. Okay, gargoyle, that's monster.
Boy, where the fuck are you going?
Wouldn't mind a looky.
We don't really have a lot of great stuff here. We don't have any money. I think we just mess with this later. And we don't have, we don't have any good formulas, I don't think, right? Well, we do have hunting boots. Those aren't quite as good. Quieten Gambeson. lightweight, not amazing. Ursine armor. Yeah, just level one stuff. Okay.
So long.
How can I help you?
God, even more Gwent. This is just the Gwent episode.
Up for a few rounds of Gwent?
Go ahead and get it in, though. Okay, she's got Aridin, so she's gonna do monster stuff. It's hard if I don't get a frost. I think I gotta try to roll for a frost here. Okay. I think one of those is probably fine. Alright. Does this have a, is this the double row one? Oh, give me him. Yeah. Double, so that's a free horn for the front row. Very good. So they're probably gonna get round one. We're just gonna put a spy up there. Yeah, that's the really good one. Because I can't resurrect that one. He gets extra cards for it. Alright, we're just gonna lead out free cards, and then hopefully we gotta get him to use his horn. Wow, he's got a fog too. Wait, no, he can't use another horn. I don't think you can have two. I don't think it'll let you do that. Can I fight through a horn? I mean, I've got my own horn on the back row. If he doesn't have torrential rain. So do I go for... I guess I go for tight bond. I just... Actually, maybe I'll hold on to this and just commit... hard for the horn. Just go hard for my own horn and try to keep up that way, then we can use tight bond next round. It does not double if they are a hero card though. So that's the one time if they have a hero card that it's good for us. Oh, we passed. Okay. Pretty tricky one. Do I use, I don't think I can horn this. So I'd have to either use, this is fogged. It's actually a really good play. I have to use one of these or one of my catapults or the horn. So if I use one of these, that effectively is like using 12. Because if both of these together, it's 16. And one of them solo is 4. And if I horn and get this one, that's worth 8. Two of these are worth either 10 or 11. So I guess this is the least value. stuff up, and then use his passive. Get to draw a card, come on. Not great. And he's up a card. This is gonna be tough. We probably should have held on to that. I'm not playing very well. I'm a little tired. Oh yeah, that's it. Yeah, I should not have played that. Because we're just going to have to give this round to him, I think. We want to make it Morn, though. I mean, this one's worth without the other one. So let's see if we can bait his Morn out here. Okay. Alright. Have a lot of tricks. We're just gonna have to beat him on raw power next turn. So I should have just put out like Zoltan and her or something like that. If he has one more summon. We still do have our horn, but maybe. If they just have a bunch of junk we can't summon. Oh, torrential rain! Oh my god. Brutal. We might lose to her. Get a summon. Yeah, the monsters ones, they're definitely some that can beat you. If you don't, like, you have to have certain kinds of cards to beat them. A lot of times you have to have a Biting Frost or you're just not going to be able to beat them a lot of times. I'm just going to lose, I think. I mean, we'll... it's our first loss. Alright, so we'll get back there next time. We'll try to have our revenge. And we will go talk to the Bloody Baron. So anyways, that's going to be it. Thank you very much. Have a good day. And Bloody Baron does open up a lot of... If we get to talk to him this early. I can't remember if we have to do a quest or not first. But he's a very important character to the story. So we will have some story progression. And, yeah, I won't spoil anything for you. But anyways, thank you very much. Have a good day, and we'll see you next time.